These photos on your screen, have you ever seen one of these? You can find them all over the world. Every country has its own design, but they all serve the same purpose. These are benchmarks. So hopefully today, I'll tell you some things that you didn't know. In the UK, heights are measured above mean sea level. In the USA and Canada, heights are not measured above sea level. Have you got that? They are not measured above sea level. Also today, after you've watched this video all the way to the end, it's only a few minutes, so I'm sure that you can spare just a short time to learn something new. And I will guarantee, absolutely guarantee, that you didn't know some of what I'm about to say. So for each thing that you knew before watching this video, I want you to post a separate comment and start it with, "I already knew that," and then say what it was that you already knew. And post a separate comment for each thing that you didn't know. Start those with, "I didn't know that," and then whatever it was. Oh, and just to make it interesting, in your comment, let us know what country you're from. Okay, benchmarks. Let's get back to benchmarks. What are they? The answer is simple. They're fixed physical markers placed at a known height above a chosen reference point. As an example, you've probably already noticed, because you're eagle-eyed, that is a benchmark. Okay, that may sound a bit technical, placed at a known height above a chosen reference point. So let me explain. In this case, height just means the vertical difference between something and something else. Let's use the ground right here as our reference point. Okay, so this exact spot here, this is now officially zero. Everything, and I do mean everything, is either at the same height as this, or it's above it, or it's below it. So let's do a test. This rock here, let's say that I measure from our zero point to the ground at the base of that rock, and it's, say, I don't know, 20 centimeters above. And this other rock here, that is below our zero reference point. So it's, say, minus 20 centimeters. And that's all map heights are. It's the vertical difference between somewhere on a map and the place that your government has declared to be zero. And yes, I can already feel lots of people, they're already typing, "I already knew that," in the comments box. That's fair enough. Many people do already know, you know, about the height differences. But don't forget, stick around until the end. We're not even at the best bit yet. So, back to our little experiment. We now have three heights. We've got our zero reference point and the ground that's at the base of these two rocks here. But let's say that we want to get the height of every rock in this area. And that's maybe, I don't know, 50 or 100 rocks. To get the first two heights, we measured directly from our zero point, you know. But going back from each rock all the way back to this zero point, each time would be, well, let's just say it would take a long time. And this is where benchmarks come in. What surveyors did in every country was to measure the height difference between the zero reference point and a new location. And then they placed a physical marker or a benchmark at that new spot. In the USA, they often look like metal discs attached to rocks or embedded in concrete. In Australia, they might be rods or bolts. In Germany, sometimes even a simple cross carved into a building. As I said before, every country has its own design. Oh, just a quick point here. Benchmarks are not the same as triangulation points or trig points in the UK. Benchmarks are placed at a known height, and a triangulation point is placed at a known location. So you could say that benchmarks record the vertical position and triangulation points record the horizontal position. In the UK, there are two main types of benchmarks. There are fundamental benchmarks and lower order benchmarks. There are around 200 fundamental benchmarks across the country. This is a fundamental benchmark, this lump of concrete here. On the top of each fundamental benchmark, there's a small pillar, which you can see here. And this is a known height above the actual benchmark, which is in an underground chamber built into the bedrock. They were constructed like this so that the actual marker wouldn't be disturbed. And the height of the underground marker is precisely known. And when I say precisely, I do mean exactly that. If you live in the UK, you should be really proud of the Ordnance Survey. I'll give you one example of their precision. The fundamental benchmark in Lempeter in Wales was damaged a few years ago. So the Ordnance Survey repaired it and then re-measured its height to within 0.01 millimetres. That's a tenth of a millimetre from a reference point 270 miles away. Just think about that for a moment. Let me get my calculator out. So let's have a look. If we convert the miles to kilometers, okay, so it's around 434 kilometers, or 434 million millimeters to a zero reference point. The Ordnance Survey replaced the marker in Lempeter with an accuracy of 1 in 43 billion. You've got to respect that. Now, obviously, you don't need that sort of accuracy for everything. So, surveyors would walk away from the fundamental benchmarks and record a new height above or below it, and then mark that spot with a lower order benchmark. And there are over 500,000 lower order benchmarks in the UK. And from this new place, they would again move a short distance and record another height, and so on and so on. And this is how all governments across the world built their elevation models of their entire country, one mark at a time. They would record the height at a certain location and then move a short distance and record the next height. In the UK, these lower order benchmarks were placed on churches, bridges, brick walls, large boulders, basically anything that the OS thought would be around for a long time and it wouldn't move. If you've walked anywhere in the UK, chances are that you've gone past many, many of them without even noticing. There are a lot of them. And this is where you might want to delete the comment that you were starting to type, "I already knew that," and replace it with another one, "I didn't know that." I'll guarantee that you didn't know the next bit. In the UK, there are a number of types of lower order benchmarks, and it can be as simple as a brass screw or a brass bolt in a wall or a flush bracket. And this type is many, you know, I'll put one on the screen. This is very common, a broad arrow pointing to a horizontal line. And it's the exact top edge of that line, which is the recorded height that the Ordnance Survey use. Did you know that? Oh, the broad arrow, by the way, it's a symbol that's been used for over 700 years to show that something belongs to the crown, and later to mark government property. Virtually all benchmarks in the UK can be checked on the open source Ordnance Survey database. And this tiny little bolt here in the middle of the mountains is a rivet lower order benchmark, and its number 136,164. And as well as its height of 446 meters, 23 centimeters, and 9 millimeters, the database also shows it was positioned in 1954 with its exact grid reference. So if you have access to the database and you're reasonably good at reading a map, GPS just simply isn't accurate enough. then you can have loads of fun finding these little tiny 1 centimeter sort of bits of metal stuck into rocks. I know. I need a more exciting hobby. Let's say that we wanted to create a new benchmark nearby, or we could use the height of this rivet, and let's say we do a survey and we find out that our next spot is 12,345 meters above this rivet, which is, don't forget, 446 meters, 239. We just need to add the two numbers together, and that would give us the exact height of, trying to work it out, 458579. And I know you're still ready to post your comments. I already knew that. But hold on, just for now. As I said, especially if you live in Canada, New Zealand, Germany, or depending on when you're watching this video, Australia. I'll put some maps on your screen. Okay, so the first one will be a UK map. And the next one, this is an American map. And here's a Canadian map. And this is a map from New Zealand. They all have heights on them, showing the difference between various places and zero. But here's the question, where is zero? Now, most people will say, oh, that's simple. It's the average sea level, because that's what your teacher told you, or your scout leader. Everybody knows that, right? You can look it up online. As an example, I know that in the US, the official National Park Service website says that Death Valley is 855 meters below sea level. And I looked the other day, and a Canadian university said that Mount Logan is 5959 meters above sea level. The New Zealand government says that the summit of Mount Cook is 12,218 feet above sea level. There's just one small problem with those websites. They're all wrong. Okay, we're used to government websites being inaccurate, but a university website, they really should know better, you know. So post your comments for the next bit with, I didn't know that. Let's break this down. In the UK, if you see a height on a map or a survey document, that is the vertical difference between that spot and the average tidal readings taken in Newlyn in Cornwall back in the 1920s. So yes, in the UK, heights are measured above mean sea level, but not so in the USA, Canada, and New Zealand, and soon Australia. Oh, I know I mentioned Germany. I'll talk about that in a moment. All I can say on heights in Germany is they are very strange. In those countries, official map heights don't actually tell you how high you are above sea level. And yes, I know that even Wikipedia uses the phrase sea level. What can I say? That's just another website that's wrong. In the USA and Canada, heights are not measured above sea level. Have you got that? They are not measured above sea level. Somewhere around the coast. They're all taken from a single point in Quebec. I think it's called the Rimouski reference point. I'll put the link in the description. Yes, you heard that right. The United States of America doesn't have its own zero base height. So it has to use one in Canada. I'll just let that sink in for a moment. Imagine telling certain Americans that their mountains, their roads, their backyard altimeters, they all take their orders from Quebec in Canada. Now, I'm not saying that's controversial, but you can imagine why it's not very well known or publicized in the USA. In New Zealand, it's not even a physical place. All New Zealand heights are based on a mathematical model of the Earth. And Australia? Well, all I can say is they're moving towards using what I can only describe as a glorified Excel spreadsheet. So now you can start typing. I didn't know that. Oh yeah, for anybody living in Germany, the heights on your maps have nothing at all to do with the sea level in northern Germany, regardless of what anybody else tells you. They're actually based on the sea level in Amsterdam, in Holland. Well, they're not really based on the sea level in Amsterdam. They are based on the sea level 300 years ago in Amsterdam. Have you ever seen that on any website or heard it on a video or read it in a book? All of which are created by experts. Wherever you are, there is always, and I mean always, something interesting. This is Tawley Edge. And at first glance, other than the wall with lots of benchmarks, there doesn't actually appear to be much else around this area. This has got nothing to do with benchmarks, has it? Let's stop all this waffle and get back to benchmarks. What was I saying? Oh yeah, benchmarks. After watching this video, hopefully you've learnt a few things that you didn't know before you watched it. And the main thing is, in some countries, benchmarks show a height above sea level. But in a lot of countries, they don't. You know, it shows the height above a specific spot that that government has decided will be zero. Anyway, as always, thanks for watching.